well listener. We shall take So taking one more note per entry. Okay. Let me take a couple of other notes here. Okay. So let me now put an agent. Okay. Say UDP agent. Let this transmit. Let this transmit. Okay. Let us take null agent. Let this receive. And let this receive. Okay, this one should be connected with this, and this one should be connected with this. Okay, let us now take application CBR starting from 1, end time 100. Okay, let us connect 1 with UDP 0, let us connect 1 with UDP 1. Okay, in parameters. Let us give simulation time as 100. Let us call this soh_energy.tr and soh_energy.none. Let us get the TCL file. In the TCL file, in order to configure the energy, what we shall do is we should put an energy config section. In this we define an energy model where each node will be having some initial energy, let us say 30 per packet, transmission energy 1.5, reception energy 0.5, ideal power and sensing power. Let us set this as D drive NS2 user bin soh_energy.tcl. Okay, now when we execute this /ns soh_energy.tcl. So because we have given 100 seconds, the simulation will be running for a longer period of time. So once we define the energy model over here, the nodes will transmit through the shortest path. Once the energy of the shortest path gets low, it will select an alternative path. Okay. So what name we have given?
soh_energy.num.
soh_energy.num. Where is that file? Oh, it would get created in. Here, okay. Because I was running them from that NS2 directory. Okay. So now what we shall do is we shall run it with num. It's got a problem here, so I'm going to open the same file soh_energy. See, initially all nodes are having good enough energy. Okay, so now you should start the simulation process. So the data transmission is going on. This way. So as the data transmission is going on, few nodes will be low on their energy. Immediately, its color is going to get changed. So this node will be losing its energy over here. Its color is going to get changed. Its color is going to get changed. Now any node which loses its energy will be entirely red color. So when a node becomes red, the data transmission will be through a different node. Now this is the only green color node available. Now the packet, whatever remaining packet they'll be having, all the transmitters have got got exhausted with the energy. So now there is no data transmission. So what we are going to do is we are going to make some changes in our energy model, okay? And we'll say transmission energy is transmit power is 0.3, okay, and receive power is say 0.5, and let us save it. Let us recompile this. So by varying the energy values over here, we can create a network graph by means of which differential data transmission through energy efficient path can be achieved. So let us now pull it back here. Let me open. All the receivers have got their energy loss, so there will be no transmission. In similar way, so you can think about a topology. See, in this way, I have created one topology. The node is moving. The entire data transmission is through this node. Once this gets energy loss, okay, if it has got sufficient energy, this should be transmitting through this node. This is a pure energy model where it shows what is the energy level. When the energy level starts going zero, this will become zero. So in this way, what you could do is you could config the nodes, okay, and you could put the energy model into the node config. So energy model is automatically going to bring in the energy aware routing. It's going to change EODV with respect to energy aware routing. So you can ideally think about a criteria where you make a network something like this, okay, two nodes here, such that one node is very near to another node, but it also can get connected with this node, such that initially all the data communication will be going through this path because it will be handling a lot of energy. Okay, this node will die immediately. The transmission path will be shifted through this particular node.